The most favorite remainder question type on GMAT. This is the standard question. A number leaves remainder 93 with 120. What remainder will it leave with 40? The concept is that for a number to leave remainder R with D, it has to be of the form D into P plus R, where P is a positive integer. For example, in this case, the number we are looking for, let's say X, has to be of the form 120 into a positive integer plus 93, and that is why 120P is leading to a remainder of 0 and 93 is leading to a remainder of 93, and therefore practically the remainder is 93. Alright, so the required number is 120p plus 93, the remainder with 40. Now imagine 120p when divided by 40 is going to give remainder 0 no matter what p is, because 120 is a multiple of 40. 93 will always give remainder 13 with 40, and therefore practically the answer is 0 plus 13, 13. Try these questions. Please pause the video, do these yourself. The number is of the form 150k. Plus 87. With 50, this part will give 0, this part will give 37. So the answer is 37. With 30, 150k will give 0, 87 will give 27. So the answer is 27. With 25, 150k will give 0, 87 will give 12. So the answer is 12. With 15, 150k will give 0, 87 will also give 12. So the answer is 12. With 6, 150k will give 0, 87 will give 3, so the answer is 3. With 300, 150k can give 150 itself when k is odd, and 150k can give 0 when k is even. And therefore, it is 150 or 0 plus 87, because 87 when divided by 300 will give 87 remainder. So in this case, there are two possible answers, 150 plus 87, 237. Or 0 plus 87, 87. This was the concept, guys. GMAT shorts are deliberately kept brief. For an elaborate explanation, please refer the stage 1 videos. Thanks for watching.